Hello Taurus and welcome back to the channel. Today we are going to go over your reading for April. Let's get started. The first card you get is Five of Cups. And it seems like you're starting the month with something that's not working out. Position, you have the moon. This could indicate a refusal to let go of. It could be the grief. It could be the something that didn't work out. And despite it not working out, you're trying to force it to work out. Or overall, your intuition was telling you something was not working. And you were attempting to ignore your intuition. Ignore that gut feeling, and now you're a little upset with yourself because in the back of your mind you're like, I knew this was going to happen and now it has happened. But in your foundation you do have the Sun card, so despite these things not working out, whatever this was, there is still hope for other things. Could be hope that this will work out. It could be a changing of the way you're approaching this situation and it will work out. But despite the feeling of disappointment overall, in this month there is happiness. There are things to be happy about. When it didn't work out, and moving forward in April, this is you healing, letting go, getting through this grieving process, because the sleepless nights, the overthinking, the anxieties, all of that is moving into your past position. What's coming towards you with that Seven of Pentacles is you evaluating the approach, basically. Is the juice worth the squeeze? Weighing up your options, the way you're attacking things, the way that you're approaching these things, and a needing to get out of the analysis paralysis. In the future position, you have the Ace of Wands, so this is a new job, a new opportunity coming in for you. This could be a new position, a promotion, more money coming in. Whatever this goal is that you're working towards, it's going to bring about the opportunity that you are looking for. Inwardly, you have the Seven of Cups. So there could be a bit of confusion, and still with that analysis paralysis there, you are weighing up options. You have a bunch of options in front of you, and this is asking you to use your intuition to help you make a decision which way to go, which cup to choose. Using that intuition is going to be your greatest asset. It will never steer you wrong. This is you spending time with your soul tribe, your family, your friends. There is a lot of support from those around you. Reach out if you feel like you need to talk or vent or ask for advice. In your hopes and fears, you have the Magician. And this is you hoping that you can manifest this opportunity. And with that Ace of Wands in your future position, this is you manifesting that opportunity. In your outcome position, you have the Knight of Pentacles. So there's an idea or an opportunity or a goal, wish, or dream of yours that the tarot is telling you that you need to get moving on. Make a decision and commit. You need to plant the seeds so that you can start reaping the rewards from this. Next, we have your oracle cards. The first card you get is maturity. So I feel like there was an idea that you had, and in the past you planted the seeds, and now you're expecting to see the fruition from your hard work, just like with that Seven of Pentacles. But with that Five of Cups, I feel like what you're gaining from this is not exactly what you're wanting or what you had envisioned for yourself. This could be people watching your every move and trying to copy what you do. But for most of you, I feel like this is you seeing someone else attain what you are trying to attain. And you're comparing yourself to others. There's not a set timeline that you need to follow. And comparing yourself to others is just going to make you feel like everything you're doing, it's not happening fast enough, or it's not good enough. Keep your eyes on the prize. Keep moving forward. Make strides where you can. Make a choice and commit to whatever it is that you're wanting to do. The next card you get is support. And just like with that Three of Cups, there is support around you. Family, friends, they're here to help you. If there's something that you're needing from them, whether it's just to go out, get your mind off your work, or if you need to vent to them or ask for advice, there are people here that are more than willing to help you. They support you and want to see you succeed. Next, we have your Moon Oracle cards. First card you get is Full Moon in Libra. A win-win outcome is forecast. You're going to succeed. You are that magician. You can turn this opportunity into whatever reality that works for you. You have all the support you need. You have all the gifts, skills, and abilities you need to succeed. You just need to get going on this. It's telling you, you have everything. Start working on it. Start making strides so that you can start seeing results. Even if you're only taking 2 steps a week towards this, it's better than none. Things don't just happen overnight, and it's telling you to put in that time. Next, times feel scary, it means I am on the right path. I feel like this goes in on what we've been talking about with your goal, wish, or dream you have. Making progress, no matter how small, is going to get you there. Things take time, and they do not happen overnight. Do not be afraid to take this one step at a time. Trust the universe has your back, and use your intuition and push forward. Thank you for sitting with me through this reading. If this reading resonated with you, or you like this style reading, please consider liking, subscribing, commenting down below. Thank you, and have a beautiful day.